So I just saw this comment on one of my videos, and I think it's a really common mistake, so I would like to address that. So here we are trying to solve the equation x squared plus 25 is equal to 0, and we see that 25 is equal to 5 squared. Next, we see that we have the square here and also the square here, so maybe we can put it as parentheses with x plus 5 inside, and then square. Okay, and then lastly, we just get x is equal to 5 or x is equal to negative 5. Well, here's the deal. From here to here is true, that's okay. But from here to here, this is actually not correct. So be careful, even though we have square here and square here, but this is an addition, this is not how you factor and get this. Why though? Let me just show you. Notice if you have x plus 5 squared, this is the same as saying x plus 5 times x plus 5. When you have two of them, right, write it down twice. And then you will have to multiply it out. This times this is x squared. This times this is plus 5x. Continue, take this now times this, it's plus 5x. Lastly, take this times that, it's plus 25. So as you can see, x squared plus 10x and then plus 25. So if you expand it, you get this. This is not the same as that, because here we have the middle term, but here we didn't have the middle term, so that's not true. Moreover though, from here to here, suppose you didn't have that, from here to here, you also don't get two solutions either. This is also not true. I think what the person was thinking is that if you have x squared, it's equal to 25 already, then yes, you can just take the square roots on both sides and put a plus or minus and say that x is equal to plus or minus 5. But when we have this right here, you will have to take the square roots both sides first. And this and that will cancel. You will just have 0. And then you will just get x plus 5 equal to 0. And you end up with just one answer, x is equal to negative 5. All right? So there are a few things that are incorrect here. So how exactly are we going to do this right though? So here I'll show you guys two ways to solve this. First way, this is a sum of two squares. We don't want that. We want to look at this as a difference of two squares. Let me show you how. Here is x squared. Instead of the plus, I will put it as minus negative 25. So this is still the same as that. Now, this is x squared. And then minus. What will give us negative 25 though? Well, we will have to use the imaginary number I. So here's the deal. This right here is equal to 5i squared. Why though? Well, firstly, I will just make a note that I is the imaginary unit so that I squared gives you negative 1. So I squared will give us the negative and then 5 squared will give us the 25. So that's how we are going to do it. Next, we have a difference of two squares now, so we can factor with the difference of two squares formula. So another note is that if we have a squared minus b squared, this is just equal to a minus b times a plus b, like this. So this right here, we can factor it and we get x minus 5i times x plus 5i. Now, this times this is equal to 0, so you can put the first factor to be 0, and the next factor to be 0. From here though, just add 5i to both sides, so x is equal to positive 5i. From here, subtract 5i to both sides, so x is equal to negative 5i. And there we have it. These are the answers to the original equation. How about the second way though? It's actually much quicker. Let's have a look. Okay, x squared plus 25 equals 0. This is just x squared. I want to keep it by itself. So let's subtract 25 to both sides. So x squared equals negative 25. Then we have to get rid of the square. We can do so by taking the square roots to both sides. So do it here, and this and that will cancel, and you just have to put a plus or minus on the right hand side. Some people say put the absolute value here, but it's easier to just put a plus or minus on the right hand side like this. Anyways, x is equal to, we have both plus or minus. Here's the deal. When we see a square root of negative, that's a time that we are going to use the imaginary unit I. And the square root of 25 is 5. So we have two answers, 5i or negative 5i, just like what we have over there. So that's it.